गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन दिस टुडेस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग द मेथड्स फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विद द हेल्प ऑफ एंड एस्टर. बाय द हेल्प ऑफ एस्टर वी कैन प्रिपेयर द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो लेट अस सी जनरल रिप्रेजेंटेशन फॉर द कार्बोक्सिलिक एस्टर. हियर आर सी डबल बॉन्ड वो आर डैश एस्टर. Ester on hydrolysis, it will produce the respective carboxylic acid. Here, R, C double bond OH, and the another product is the alcohol. Okay? Alcohol is the byproduct and main product is the carboxylic acid. When the esters undergo hydrolysis, then it will use the compound called carboxylic acid. When the esters react with the base solution, it is sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, then it will produce the compound called sodium salt of carboxylic acid, which on further hydrolysis produces the carboxylic acid. Okay. Here, then example is CH3. C double bond O CH3 when undergo hydrolysis, then it will produce the compound called ester, that is it will produce the carboxylic acid. Here the carboxylic acid is an acetic acid, general name is an acetic acid, and another byproduct is the alcohol, that is methyl alcohol. When these esters, by the help of esters on hydrolysis, it will produce the carboxylic acid. And when we take the example of an methyl acetate undergo hydrolysis, then it will produce the compound acetic acid and alcohol, that is methyl alcohol. When these esters react with, that is R, C double bond O, OR dash, when react with alkali solution, that is alkali solution, we can take the NaOH or KOH, then it will produce the compound card, that is R C double bond O, O and A. Here the ROH will be eliminated. The sodium salt of carboxylic acid will be formed here, which on hydrolysis, that is acid hydrolysis, it will produce the compound called an R C double bond O OH, that is carboxylic acid will be formed by reacting with the base. The example we can take same, that is methyl acetate when react with the sodium hydroxide, that will use the sodium salt of carboxylic acid or sodium acetate, then further hydrolysis it will produce the compound called and carboxylic acid. The carboxylic acid is the acetic acid. Then let us, this is about the and methods of preparation for the carboxylic acid. At the next topic we will see the physical properties of a carboxylic acid. Physical properties of carboxylic acid. Whenever we taking the physical properties, first we have to understand three points. One is nature, and another one is solubility. The second one is the solubility, and third one is the MP and P. MP and P, that is melting point and boiling point. Then let us see the nature of an carboxylic acid. First point, that is nature. From carbon 1, 2, 3, that is C1 to C3, are an pungent liquid, that is and from C4 to C7, that is approximately C10, these are an oily liquid. These are the oily liquid at higher member or the solid in nature. From C1 to C3 are present liquid, and the C4 to C10 are oily liquid, and the higher members are present in the solid form. Then the second one, solubility. The solubility of carboxylic acid in the water will increase with a decrease in the number of carbon atom in the parent structure. That is, the solubility of water, that is lower carboxylic acid will be more soluble in the water. Will be more soluble. Whereas, when increase in the number of carbon atom in the parent shell, the solubility will be decreases because the longest the carbon chain is an hydrophobic in nature. That is, hydrophobic. Due to the hydrophobic nature of hydrocarbon part, these are less soluble in the water. Whenever increase in the number of carbon atom, the hydrophobic character also increases. Therefore, the solubility will decreases. The third one, MP and PP. The melting point and boiling point generally increase in the number of carbon atom. The parent shell increases the PP and MP. Then increase in the branches, then decreases the PP and MP. Here, in the carboxylic acid, the carboxylic acids are involved in the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That is, these are involved in the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Because of this intermolecular hydrogen bonding, the carboxylic acids will have the greater BP and MP. Okay. Then, next products, these are about the physical properties. Next, we will see the chemical properties. Okay. The chemical properties. In the chemical properties, we will see the reactions involving, that is first one, reactions involving cleavage of OH bond. Okay? The heading is reactions involving the cleavage of an OH bond. Let us see first one, reaction with metal, that is alkali metal, or we can take simply metal, reaction with the metals. Then metal, we can take the sodium or potassium. When the carboxylic acids, that is R, C, O, double bond O, OH, react with the sodium metal, that it will produce and sodium salt of carboxylic acid, that is R, C, double bond O, and that is ONA, with the liberation of an hydrogen gas here. The liberation of hydrogen gas. That balance the reaction here, 2, then here 2, then here also 2. Okay. When the carboxylic acids react with the metals, then it will give the salt of an carboxylic acid with the liberation of an hydrogen gas. Okay. So here let us take the example CS3. C double bond OH, the compound is the acetic acid. when acetic acid react with the sodium metal, we can take the potassium also there. An example that is here CH3, that is plus 2 number of one sodium metal react with the acetic acid, it produces the compound that is balancing the reaction here. CH3 C double bond O O and A, that is sodium acetate, sodium salt of carboxylic acid, the particular name of this compound is, and sodium acetate. This is the liberation of an hydrogen gas. Okay. The liberation of hydrogen gas. Let us take note here. In the note, this type of reactions can be shown by the alcohols or alcohols and phenols. This reaction can be shown by the alcohols and phenols. That is, the alcohols can react with the sodium metal, then it will use the liberate the hydrogen gas, and when the phenol can react with the sodium metals to form the sodium phenoxide. Then let us take second one, reaction with sodium hydroxide, that is alkali solution. Reaction with the sodium hydroxide. We can take the potassium hydroxide also here. Totally, the alkali solution must be taken. When the carboxylic acid reacts with the sodium hydroxide, then it will use the compound sodium salt of carboxylic acid and water molecules. So let us see the reaction here. R C double bond O OH carboxylic acids, when react with the sodium hydroxide, that is alkali solution, then it will produce the compound called, that is RC double bond O O and A plus water molecule. So here the compound is sodium salt of and carboxylic acid. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid. And we can simply write the acids. Then balance the reaction. That is number of sodium 1, the number of hydrogen 2, number of hydrogen 2, R1, the number of oxygen is 1, 2, 3, and number of oxygen is 1, 2, 3. It is a balanced chemical reaction. Then let us take the example here. In the place of carboxylic acid, CH3, C double bond O, OH, that is example, acetic acid. General name is the acetic acid, and icon name is the, then ethanoic acid. Icon name is the ethanoic acid. When the acetic acid react with the sodium hydroxide, then it will use the compound called sodium salt of and carboxylic acid. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid, here sodium acetate is the compound name, and water molecules. Here the compound is sodium acetate. Then let us take the note here. One note. This reaction can be shown only by the phenol. This type of reactions only shown by the phenols, not by the alcohols. Okay? Phenols can show this type of reaction, but the alcohols will not show. Alcohol cannot show the this type of reaction. Alcohol will not show the reactions, and whereas phenols can show the reaction by the phenol react with the sodium hydroxide, that will give the compound sodium phenoxide and water molecule. Okay. Here these are the two reactions the third one we will see, that is third one, reaction with, that is third one, reaction with and sodium bicarbonate. Okay, the third one is the reaction with the sodium bicarbonate. This is about the today's class. The next class we will discuss the reactions of and carboxylic acid towards the sodium bicarbonate. Okay, thank you.